Part 5 of the 7-part series on the beautiful St. Lava Pass covers the section from the 22nd to the 26th kilometer. If you intend driving this pass, it's important to watch parts 1, 2, 3 and 4 sequentially, which include the orientation animation and flyover clips, as well as other important information on safety, history and tourism. For the next 1.5 kilometers, you'll be able to enjoy spectacular views to the left over the river and the gorge. Continuing with the modern history of the Transkei, between April 1978 and April 1980, Matanzima engaged in a dispute over the status of Griqualand East and broke off diplomatic ties with the apartheid government and threatened an end to the non-aggression pact. Weeks later, with its economy bankrupt, the homeland was forced to accept a bailout of 73 million rand from the diplomatically alienated South African government. This grant was in addition to an annual grant of 113 million rand for the 79-1980 financial year. Between 1978 and 1980, South African grants amounted to approximately 573 million rand. Corruption in the homeland drastically depleted its funds, and in 1980 the South African state assumed control over the homeland's budget. When the Minister of Education, Stella Sigcau, was fired in 1979, a cabinet crisis ensued, and the opposition Progressive Democratic Party was formed under the leadership of Dalendi Yabo, Matanzima's old rival. But Matanzima used his state powers against his opponent. Trumped-up charges against Dalendi Yabo saw him convicted on a minor charge, but he was acquitted of the more serious charges. There was much public support of Dalendi Yabo, and the Transkei administration suffered great embarrassment. In 1980, most of the members of the opposition DPP were arrested and some were banned. Dalendi Yabo fled and went into exile in Zambia, where he forged links with the ANC. He died in 1986. However, Matanzima's TNIP party was also rocked by splits and divisions during 1979 and 1980. The party lost support in East Pondoland when the powerful Sigcau clan switched sides and allied with the DPP. Matanzima decided to appoint his brother George as Prime Minister whilst he assumed the position of President. George Matanzima's brutal attempts to centralize control resulted in a further disintegration of the tribal alliances his brother had so painstakingly constructed. The entire ruling apparatus was racked by crises. Heavy repressive measures saw many opposition leaders, former cabinet ministers, and the head of the defense force and the police detained. The former Rhodesian Selu scout General Ron Reed Daly was appointed head of the Transkei Defense Force. In 1985, apartheid practitioners conceived a plan to merge the Transkei and Ciskei and create a united nation of Xhosa speakers who they thought would support the South African government and help it to stamp out unrest in the Eastern Cape. Matanzima had long held ambitions to rule such territory and had opposed the independence of the Ciskei in 1981 in the hope that his merger would be realized. But the plan, which included having Ciskei's president Lennox Sebe assassinated, failed after it was leaked to General Bantu Holomisa. Matanzima began to lose support by the mid-1980s and resigned in 1986, but he managed to retain his seat as Paramount Chief of Western Tembuland. He was succeeded as president by Paramount Chief Tutu Ngangaliswe Ndamasi, the son of Chief Victor Porto of Western Pondoland. George Matanzima, who had been embroiled in disputes with his brother, was effectively sidelined, but the conflicts intensified and brought much turbulence to Transkei politics in the period from 1986 to 1989. Eventually, both Chief Victor Porto and George Matanzima were overthrown amid charges of corruption in government departments. Others also lost their positions, including Reed Daly, the head of the Transkei Defense Force. He was replaced by General Zondwa Mtarira in April 1987. At this point, the road approaches the double villages of Choto and Sikulweni. A sharp double apex left-hand bend of 170 degrees reverses the direction into the northeast and marks the start of the double switchback section ahead of the bridge crossing. You will have descended a total of 864 vertical meters at this stage. Be sure to watch part 6 and 7 of the Umsund Lava Pass.